Hey guys, this is BLN437 here. I hope you guys are having a great day today. Any of you guys that are new, welcome. And any of you guys that are returning, welcome back to the channel. I hope you guys are having a great day. I know that I am, now that I'm playing Red Dead Redemption instead of MLB Battle Royale. Because, God, those servers are just annoying to play with right now. But I just want to apologize again if I sound any different. I just had my wisdom tooth extraction 2 days ago on Monday, so I'm still dealing with that, and I'm still dealing with the cold. But I just wanted to do a video for you guys today, so I'm gonna pull through, do a video, and try to have some fun. I also wanted to just say I'm not gonna really talk much during this gameplay, just to kind of heal up and to kind of make myself a little bit better, since I'm still in a little bit of pain and I am still sick. But I hope you guys enjoyed this. If you guys like this video, please leave a like, share this video with all of your friends, and don't forget to subscribe. So let's get into this cutscene.
Mr. Marston, I've been hearing about your plans.
Have you, Miss McFarlane?
Yes, from Lee Johnson, to settle here and build a life for yourself.
I'm afraid those aren't my plans. See, I already have a life. Well, I had one, and I'm trying to reclaim it. Or maybe what you could say is I had two, and I'm trying to end one of them so the other can survive.
You do so love to talk in riddles, Mr. Marston. Do you do that, I wonder, as a substitute for having anything interesting to say?
Probably, Miss McFarlane.
Oh, call me Bonnie, you fool. Call me Bonnie.
Miss McFarlane, I'm married. I have a son. I had a daughter, but she died. Years before that, I rode in a gang. We robbed banks, trains, held people ransom. We killed people we didn't like. Bill Williamson was in that gang. Now, if I don't capture my former brother in arms, great harm will befall my family. Now, I don't suppose any of this is very interesting to you, but I hope it explains why I wasn't so eager to talk about it.
No, I do understand. I had no idea. You poor man.
Even in this new country, memories don't really fade. My father was an illiterate Scot born on a boat into New York. He never saw his homeland, but to hear him talk about it, you'd imagine he only ever ate haggis and wore a kilt. And he hated the English for what they had done to his great-grandparents that he'd never met. People don't forget. Nothing gets forgiven.
That's true. Especially when it comes to money. And you know, even now, after all his labors, my father's debts are still terrible. I worry every day about us losing the ranch. It would kill him.
My father died when I was 8 years old. His eyes were, well, let's just say he was blinded in a bar fight south of Chicago. My mother died during childbirth. She was a prostitute and he was her, well, I don't know what he was. So I was sent off to an orphanage and ran away and fell in with a gang.
My word. What a difficult life you've lived.
The leader of the gang taught me how to read, taught me how to see all that was good in the world. He was a great man in a way.
But you killed people.
Sure. And I've suffered for it. And that's the life I left. I tried to leave. Said too much. I'm an uneducated killer, sent here to do all I can do well. Kill a man in cold blood so that another man may do his part to cut crime in an area, and a rich man can be elected governor on the back of these promises.
Civilization is a truly beautiful thing, Mr. Marston. Listen, can you help me?
Well, I can try. What do you need, money?
No, nothing so complicated. I need an extra hand to take out the herd to pasture.
Sure. Point me in the right direction.
That cutscene is really done really, really well. I mean, it finally starts to give us some of the reason for why John does what he does. And it really starts to pick up. Which I think is great. When, you know, that we have this character development this early in the game where he's kind of now starting to open up about the motives of why he's an armadillo and why he's doing what he's doing.
It must have been hard for you.
Hope you understand now why I've been playing my cards somewhat close to my chest.
I didn't know you had a wife and child. Then again, I don't think I ever asked. They're lucky to have a man like you.
I ain't so sure about that, but thank you.
But yeah, I mean, so that cutscene was done really, really well. I know that we've done a bunch of Bonnie missions, so the next mission we're gonna switch it up.
Sir?
We're gonna bring some different type of, you know, pace and action to this game. We're gonna start doing the Marshal missions in the next one, so just stay tuned for this one. We're gonna do a quick herd of the cows and put them to the pen, and I think you take them to the oak tree or whatever. And then once we do that, we'll head to Armadillo and we'll start doing stuff with the Marshal. And as you guys can see, I'm having a little bit of trouble here with the herd. I haven't done this in such a long time, so it takes me a while to kind of get into that, like, oh yeah, this is how you do it, you know, so. So as you guys can see right now, I'm struggling with it, but I got better with it as we went forward. The horse one is going to be the one that's really going to kill me. I don't know if you guys remember the one or the mission where you guys, like, have to, like, lead the horse to the traps by, like, the caves or whatever. And then the stallion breaks loose. That mission, I don't know why. It always takes me like about a good 10 to 20 minutes to do. I don't understand it. I don't know why, but it does. It literally takes me that long. So hopefully it doesn't take me that long in this playthrough when we do it. So I don't know. But the graphics in this game, they look so nice. And here we are now right near the where these herd is at. And then we got to lead them to the oak tree. And as you guys can see, I'm having trouble again with the herd, but we'll get the hang of it. We'll get the hang of it because I have to do this again anyways towards the end of the game, which I'm not gonna really explain too much about what happens there. But at the end of the game, we have to pretty much do a lot of this stuff. So this is a great introduction to what you have to do later on to me. Oh please, Bonnie, we'll get this. We'll do this. Oh, you wouldn't say I'm a natural, huh? Well, soon, Bonnie. I haven't done this in 6 years. Well, I shouldn't say six, but I haven't done this in a while. It hasn't been 6 years. It's probably been like five or four, but still, I haven't done it in such a long time, Bonnie. All right, we did it successfully. Took a little long, but we did it.
Ranching might be your true calling, Mr. Marston. Either that, or you were a cow in a past life.
Thank you, Miss McFarland.
I'll see you later. I have work to do back at the ranch.
You just said I wasn't a natural. What am I, a natural? Or I'm not a natural? I mean, what is it, Bonnie? And we made our first $5 of the game, but what is it? Am I a natural at this? Am I not? Because now you're saying that I am, or that at least I could be a rancher. Jesus, Bonnie. Mixed signals. That's not good. Alright, so let's head to Armadillo, guys. Let's get this done. Let's start doing some Johnson missions, the Marshal. These are probably my favorite missions of the game, like the Marshal missions, because it gets that, like, old Wild West type vibe, and I love it. The path to becoming a true legend is long and hard. Try shooting birds or skinning coyotes to start on your way. So if you guys don't know, there's a legend meter, and then that legend meter, the higher it goes, the more people randomly start to know about your heroics and what you've done. So let's say that there's a bunch of bandits that are, like, raiding the town. If I take care of them, I get notoriety for it and recognition and just so forth, you know, so on and so forth. But let me stop talking and let you guys get to the cutscene.
Thank you. consistent, but we're baffled. Only when things matter.
If I'm correct, I believe this mission is pretty much we go to the saloon, we follow the guy, and then once we follow the guy to his hideout, we like eliminate all of them now. I think there's two ways to do this mission. You can kill the guy or you can like capture him. So let's see if we can capture him. Come on, horse, hurry up. Well, that's not good, Marshal, that they're all over the place like that. We gotta take care of them. Help to find people of this this fine community and fine land. Sorry guys, I hit my mic there. Oh god. You're a bad shot, man. I'll press R1 to enter and exit cover. Oh, you popped your head. You're dead. Oh, you did the same thing? Van murdered you. No, you didn't die? How? Jesus Christ, man. You can take a bullet. But now you're dead. You were shot in the head. Nice. Alright, perfect. Nice little start. Jesus, Marshal, you can shut up. I know what I'm doing. Oh, I see you. I see you. Oh, you're dead. Am I pointing at you, Marshal, or am I shooting this guy? I think I'm shooting this guy. Oh God! Oh no, he's got a shotgun. Ah! Oh well, he's dead. Oh well, we didn't really want to kill him, but hey, he was gonna kill me, so wasn't gonna let that happen. See you soon, Marshal. Did he just go down rocks? When you could have just gone down that path? Okay. Not the best way to do things, but okay. Alright, so let me just loot a couple of these bodies to get some money and some ammunition, and then we'll just do like a fast travel to Armadillo. That's such a weird thing to say. Jesus Christ. Oh, that's right, my honor went down for, shooting somebody. I should have done something more positive than just shoot the guy. So that's also a big thing in this game. Honor. If you kill people, instead of capturing them, your honor can go down. Because the righteous path, the right way of usually doing things is to have the man face the justice system. Obviously, I didn't do that. I killed him. But if I had not killed him, my honor would have went up, 100. Then down 100, but That's another thing about this, you know, when you start to shoot cops or whatever, your honor also goes down, and then there's this huge bounty, and you can either pay with money or with deeds, but, you know, that's what it is. Yes, I know the marshal left me a long way. And I know after a battle, I can search the bodies. We're going to do a quick fast travel in a minute, but I just wanted to explain how the honor system works. So if there's, like, random bandits, like there usually is in this game, that are shooting up the town or whatever it is, if you stop them, like I said, your honor does go up. Everything goes up, your fame. So that's what I like about this game. This game has a true sense of, you know what? You have to create an urban legend of yourself by doing these heroic deeds. And the more heroic deeds you do, the truer the legend, the better the man you are. So here we are, we're right by the marshal again. And this is exactly what I'm talking about. See, stopping people like that. Oh no. Yes, thank you. And as you guys can see, my fame went up. Whoa, did she just pop up after being dead? What? Did you guys see that? Dude, did you guys just see that? She literally popped up alive, then died. What the hell? That's funny. She literally was dead. Neither do I. Jeez, that marshal is such a dick at times. I mean, you don't have to call him out on his lazy eye. But, so this mission is pretty much, I believe, it's we're going up to, like, the mountains. We're going to save this guy's livestock. I can't believe that that woman is still there dead. but yeah, so that's pretty much what we're doing. And we're going to accompany the marshal and we're going to help him and his boys out. Oh, that's really true. I mean, you guys think about it. During this time, Manifest Destiny was still a thing. Sorry for my cat, guys. But I mean, if you guys think about it, Manifest Destiny was a huge thing. You know, factories were becoming a huge thing. Now we can't even live without factories and people mass-producing stuff in today's world. But, I mean, just back in those days, having to do things old school and just, you know, without technology, which I do think is a little bit of a benefit. I think that we have become too, you know, attached to technology, you know. Like, I can't even go a day without having my phone on. So I could only imagine how it would be to just like live in that time and go like maybe 10 days without a cell phone. That would be crazy for us at least, but not for them, which is crazy. But let's get on with this mission. Let's take care of these guys. Oh gosh. Oh my God, they just came out of nowhere to just start shooting us. Oh no. Come on, what the hell? Where's my aim? There we go. Oh God. Yeah, let me take a little cover there. Come on, Mars. Come on, Marshal. Follow us. Follow me. Let's take care of these guys. Oh, please. No one's gonna slow you down. Oh, Jesus. Where did he come from? Oh, he's right there. Okay. I see you. Bam, murdered you. Now let's go up. I don't see him, Marshal, but we'll see. Oh, now I do. Now I do. It's a nice job there, son. You missed your shot. See what you got. You got any money? Got $5? Okay, I can do with $5. Well, your deputies are doing a good job, but I don't mind killing that guy. Fordham. This guy's to our right. Okay, there I see him. Nope. What are you doing there, John? Aim. Oh, they weren't there. Okay, they were behind that rock, and now you're dead. And you're dead too. Short thing, Marshal. I will defend you with my honor and my life. Oh, there's a bunch of them over there. Jeez, what? That hurt me? That little jump literally hurt me that bad? Okay. Yes, you're dead. No, you're dead too. What? You didn't die? I thought I got him in the head. Oh, got him on the upper chest area or like the shoulder area? Okay. Don't know about that, but okay. Well, you're dead. And now you are. So let's see if there's some ammo around here. I know that usually the treasure cases do, or the treasure usually does have some type of chest, does have ammo. So let's see. Jesus. Revolver. Ammo. Okay. And we. Oh, there goes another treasure case. I'm just gonna run past. Let's just forget that one. Oh, that's great. Oh gosh. Well, they got me good. They got me good. Yes, it is worth living. Why would you say that, John? They want to live. But they have to die. Nice and steady now. Okay. Jesus, are these guys not able to shoot this guy? Well, I'll take care of him. Dead eye. Nice headshot. Oh God, there's more. There is more. Oh. He didn't die? Man, that guy should have died. Wait until I get like the bolt rifle and stuff, like the powerful weapons in this game. They'll be down within one or two shots. Move out of my way. I'll take the lead. Wait to regroup with the marshal and the deputies. Okay. If they can hurry up. Come on, Eli. What are we sneaking up on them for? Our weapons are gonna make a huge amount of noise anyways. So let's just run and gun these dudes. And just take cover when we need to take cover. I mean, there's no way we're sneaking past these guys. I'm not gonna kill them with a knife. And there we go, see? Look at that, a nice headshot, and he's dead. No need for all of that nonsense. See, look at that. Oh God. That guy behind a rock. Come on out, poke your head out. There you go, I see you now. Good job. Ooh. That was me, buddy. That was me, Eli. Your lazy eye couldn't see, so it was me. Ooh, nice again. I'm getting my aiming down in this game. Perfect. Now, I know you guys are going to be like, well, you used Deadeye for that shot, so... Yes, I did, but still, that was a good shot. Alright, nice. Oh, God. What happened there? Oh, I see you. You're dead. Oof. No, they won't. Hey, the people want what they want, Marshal. If they want Mr. West Dickens, they want Mr. West Dickens, even if he is selling them garbage. And he is selling them garbage. But nice to see that cattle's going to be safe. We ended up making $25, so now we're at 76. Not bad. So, guys, this is going to be the end of part number 2 of this playthrough. Our fame went up 150. We have the Nigel West Dickens stuff that we have to do. We're probably going to do another Bonnie mission just to kind of end those strings of missions so that way that can be done with. And I can start focusing on like the other portions of the game. Because the Bonnie missions are pretty much, I think we meet her father. And then after we meet her father, we meet her father and we're doing a couple other things. So it's nothing really big. It's nothing too much to do. So that's probably what we're going to do. And if you guys like this video, make sure to leave a like once again. Make sure to share this video with all of your friends. Because you guys really should share this video with all of your friends. Comment, you know, subscribe. Sorry if I sound a little bit different or if I'm slurring my words a little bit. My mouth is still killing me, but yeah, just make sure that you guys leave a like, comment, subscribe, share this video with all your friends, and I will see you guys in the next playthrough of Red Dead Redemption, which will be part 3.